Hey guys, how's it going? It's Anish here and welcome to Code Pizza. Today we are going to learn about web scraping using Python. If you don't know what web scraping is, it's about automating useful data collection from websites using computers instead of manually looking for data on websites. This makes it less tedious and just a lot faster to collect large amounts of data. We'll be using PyPTA and Beautiful Soup for this and scrape Wikipedia articles.
So PyPTA is a library ported from Node.js to Python, which helps us control a headless instance of Chromium browser using Python. This way, we can control our actions on a website as if we were using a real browser. Beautiful Soup is an HTML parser, and we would just need it to convert some HTML content into text. Now, what will this project do? It would search for a keyword on Wikipedia and find the relevant article and give us a text definition of that. Pretty simple, but you can use these techniques to scrape any kind of websites that you want. So without further ado, let's get into it. First of all, make sure you have all the libraries installed. So install PyPTA and Beautiful Soup 4 using PIP. Now import the libraries as given here. You'd need the launch function from PyPTA to launch a browser instance and the class Beautiful Soup to parse HTML. First, define an async function that will be used to search for a keyword. I will also call this function using async.io and search for the word cat. We need to launch a browser instance using the launch function. Then create a new page and then go to the Wikipedia homepage. Now if we go to the Wikipedia main page and inspect the search input field, we can see that it has an ID equals search input. So to type in our keyword, we call the type function on the page using the query selector ID equals search input to select the input field and then passing in the keyword. Let's take a screenshot of this and see the result. As you can see, we have the keyword in the input field. We use the function press from the keyboard class to press the enter key to search for this keyword. We also need to wait for the navigation to finish before processing the results. Let's take another screenshot to see the search results. Great, we can see all the search results. Now if we go to the search results in our browser and inspect the result element, we can see that all the results are in an unordered list with the class as mwSearchResults. So we need to grab all the links under the A tag and the first result would be the most relevant. To do that, we need to execute some JS code in the browser itself to fetch us all the links. PyPTA has a really handy function for this, which is evaluate, and what it does is it executes a JS function on the page and returns us the result of the function. So this little snippet here uses query selector all to select all the A tags under the mwSearchResults class. Then we map it to another array which just contains the href attributes of each of the link. Let's print these URLs. Now we need to go to the first URL that we get. If we screenshot at this stage, we get this result and as you can see, it is the Wikipedia article for a cat. Now the last step is to extract the content text from the article. If we inspect the text in the browser, we see that all the content is under p tags in the mwParser output class. So we need to get all the text inside these p tags and return it. And again, we will use the evaluate function for this. This one is similar to the last one but extracts the inner HTML of each p tag. Let's join the array of text we got as a string and see the results. As you can see, this data is HTML content, but we need only text. Here Beautiful Soup comes into play, and it will help us convert this into plain text. We just create a Beautiful Soup instance and use getText to get the text content, also strip any trailing white spaces. Now, if we print the result, we see the result is plain text. We still see these square brackets and numbers, which are references to Wikipedia articles. But we can remove them using some simple bracket logic. Also, let's strip the result down to just 500 characters, as we don't need the entire article. It's not web scraping if we cannot search for any article we want. So let's add an input to search for. We can then pass in this keyword to the main function, which will search and display the definition of this keyword. And now if we search for anything, this script will use Wikipedia to define that. Pretty good. Let's ramp it up now. I have a simple script playing around that uses Google Text-to-Speech to give speech output. So let's use that to narrate the final text that we get. Now if we search for a cat, It should define the cat with its very own voice. Not really though, it's Google's voice.
The cat Felis catus is a domestic species of small carnivorous mammal. It is the only domesticated species in the family Felidae and is often referred to as the domestic cat to distinguish it from the wild members of the family. A cat can either be a house cat, a farm cat, or a feral cat. The latter ranges freely and avoids human contact. Domestic cats are valued by humans for companionship and their ability to hunt rodents.
Whoa, that was quite a definition. But I liked it.
That was cool. And in case you were wondering, yes, I would be adding it to Friday as a task so that I can just ask her about stuff and she can reply back. If you like this tutorial, give it a thumbs up. And let me know down in the comment section if you want to see more such tutorials, or just leave a comment about what kind of content would you like to see. Hit that subscribe button now and click on that notification bell to stay tuned for some amazing content. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.